you need to say to your mom and your dad, to say, look, Islam gives me the responsibility, this amount of responsibility over me or over you. So you have to say to your mom, by the way, Islam says you have to provide education for me. Islam says that. You have to guide me aright. Islam says that. It is the Islamic obligation of parents to make sure that when they bring an offspring into the world, that they direct that child into the right path. So they're going to be useful for their deen, Islam, on one side, and they're going to be useful to the society. Because if the parents do not guide the kids aright, or do not guide the children aright, then they have failed in the responsibility over you as a child. Is that fair enough?
Yeah.
So if you don't go to school, or you need to be in school, and your mom says, Irfan, no, don't go to school today, stay at home. No. As a mother, I have an obligation on my child to make sure that he has Islamic education, and on top of that, he does have education to better Islam, which is a Western education. So the Western education ideally should be to better the progression of Islam. So if you're in school, you want to be a doctor. Why do you want to be a doctor? You want to be a doctor not for the sake of it, but you are being a doctor because you want to help humanity. And when you help humanity, you're helping Islam. Do you not want to be happy to say, oh, Dr. Irfan or Dr. Aisha in there? That is, you're bringing Islam up. It's just like scientists as well. When you go in to be a scientist, you are progressing Islam. Because one of the fundamental things as well in Islam is that you have to seek knowledge. And the knowledge that you are seeking, you are using, you're going to use that knowledge for the betterment and uplifting of Islam and your society and your community. So you want to be a good person in your community and also a good person to your religion. Are we okay? Do we understand why we need to be, you know, what kind of responsibilities that, you know, is upon me as a mother on my child? Can anyone just randomly just give me an idea of what you think a mother or a parent should do for their child? Anyone? Just randomly. It's interactive. I'll sit down though, so that we can chat. We're chatting, we're talking, you know, we're gisting actually. Yeah? Are we fair enough? I don't want to point at anyone, so. Someone say something to me, please, let's get it going. It's not meant to be boring, it's meant to be fun. Yeah? Someone's smiling at me. Hello. Do you want to tell me? Go ahead, darling. Perfect. So that is one fundamental responsibility. So they must provide food. Yeah? Perfect. Thank you so much, darling. So that's another one. So to an extent, that just shows me that, you know, some of us here know that we need to, what we expect our parents to do for us. Would that be fair enough to say that? Perfect. Now, our last one, which Allah says in the Quran, your God has decreed that thou shalt worship only Him and adopt good behavior with thy parents. That's in Quran 17:23, chapter 17, verse 23. What does that mean? It just means really that for you guys as well, Allah has decreed for us to say that, yes, we must adopt good behavior. And what we want when we look after you, we want you to adopt good behavior for us. That good behavior makes us happy. We'll go out and say, oh yes, I'm a parent of, you know, Aisha, and she's a doctor. Being a doctor, she's uplifted Islam. Not only has uplifted
benefit our community, and she's good for the humanity, which means she's treating people. Who else wants to be, you know, just randomly here? What do we all want to be in the future, and why do we want to aspire to be that? Yeah? You want to be a policeman? And why do you want to be a policeman, darling? Why do you want to put people in jail? What I'm trying to get here, because he says he wants to put people in jail. And to understand the rationale behind him wanting to put people in jail is that these people are bad. So the intention is that you're trying to get bad people off the street. Is that correct? Thank you. May Allah make it possible for you. Yes, darling. You want to be a doctor. And why do you want to be a doctor? Perfect. So you want to help people. That means you want to help humanity. And that is what you're helping Islam. Is that correct? Can we relate that? Do we all understand? Yes, my darling. Who's that? Yes, do you want to say something? You want to be a footballer. And why do you want to be a footballer? Because you're good at it. So what benefit is football going to uplift Islam? If you want, there's an Islamic footballer. What's his name now? Muhammad Salah. Now, because he's a good footballer and he's good at what he's done, what has he done? People now relate to Islam. Can you guys see, even regardless of what you do, you just need to adopt good behavior and have the mentality that, look, even being a footballer, you're giving back to your community, not only your community, but Islam as well. I hope you all agree with me, since Mohamed Salah has been prominent, there's been questions and, you know, about Islam, about his religion. Would that be correct? Would that be correct? People, when he goes to say, you know, to make a dua before he starts, you know, a football match, people can then relate to the fact that this guy is a Muslim and he's a footballer and he's good at what he's doing. We don't want, you know, to come back and say, oh, this person is a Muslim and he's a whatever in the community. We don't want that. Yes, my friend. You want to be a doctor? Why do you want to be a doctor? To help people. Why do you want to do that? Pardon? It helps humanity. So, we all know, at least to an extent, we can all agree that being good not only helps your family, your parents, it helps your community, the humanity, and Islam. At least to an extent, we all agree on that. Do we have a concession? Yeah? Yes, yes, no, yes. Who doesn't agree? It is okay to agree to disagree. If you do not disagree, give them the reason why you do not disagree. That's just all. We are having a conversation. You know, like I said, it's meant to be fun. Yeah? We're having a chat. I know you guys don't want to chat with me or something. Who's chatting this one? Yeah. But I am going to chat with you. Am I right or wrong? Sometimes. Yeah? Right, so as just to proceed, so it says as well, Imam Jafar as-Siddiq observes that three actions are the best. First, offer the first mandatory prayers with punctuality. Okay, that is one of your responsibilities as a child. And you need to give that responsibility to your parents. You don't want your parents going, Irfan, have you said your prayers? Irfan, it is time for Zuhr, it's time for Asr, it's time for Isha. You don't want that. Because that means you're giving your parents stress. But when you know that it is time for Salah, you should literally get on. I'm telling you, you bring the joy to your parents when they know that they want you to do something. And they see the result. I guarantee you that your parents are not going to be happy to see that. Okay, investing so much. Let's assume your parents are investing so much for you guys to come to this madrasa. To learn what? To learn how to read and write, you know, understand the Quran. Is that correct? Not for you to come to the madrasa and go, and that's when you start the gist of like what has happened from the beginning of the week. You go, Fatiha, do you know that I did this last week? Hey, I got this. Then you pick up the conversation in the madrasa. The madrasa is not for that conversation. Your parents are invested in you coming to learn Islam. And what they want back from you is to give it back that you're concentrating on what you've come here to learn. Because I tell you, when you grow up, you will really appreciate the efforts that your parents are putting into all of this for you. You may not see it now, but I guarantee you, when you guys grow up to be parents as well, inshallah, you shall all reap the benefit of, you know, coming to the madrasa, learning to read the Quran, or understanding the ways, you know, or the sunnahs, or hadith, understanding Islam, really. You will all reap the benefit. And then you will appreciate your teacher, you know, Brother Abdulkadir, because he's doing so much for you guys. Can we all just say Jazakallah to Brother Abdulkadir for all the efforts he's giving to you guys today, please? I know you guys really rarely get time to say thank you to him. You should always say thank you to him and say thank you to your parents as well, because it is not easy getting everyone together and getting everyone to get to teach, you know, the teachings of Allah. So when someone does come up to say, I want to do this for the sake of Allah, this is really for the sake of Allah, you should all support him because it's for your benefit. You may not see it now, but you will see it when you grow up. I'm speaking from experience. We'll take it for granted now. I grew up in a Islamic home. My father was an imam. But we didn't appreciate what my father, when we have, you know, teachers, Islamic teachers coming to my house to teach us Quran. We were so notorious, I'm telling you. With a lot of things we regret now that we wish we had listened at the time. And it is better that we all take it seriously. So we do not kind of think, oh, I should have done this, I should have done that. If I had someone to tell me that, oh, Sakina, by the way, when your Quranic teacher comes, I would be upstairs, I'm going to, oh, be saying, oh, Alaji, your children are not downstairs. Myself and my siblings would literally keep the Islamic teacher waiting downstairs. My father did so much, may Allah rest his soul. Being an imam in Lagos State, well-known imam in Lagos State, his children, we were a little bit rebellious. That's how Allah has made it. And I'm begging you guys today, please, for the sake of Allah, whatever it is your parents are pushing you to do, especially the effort they've put in here today, please, let them reap this. Because when they go to their grave, they will be asked, have they taught you the Quran? Same as all of you as well. When you die and go to your grave, one of the questions you will ask is, how did you benefit your religion? How did you benefit Islam? How did you benefit the children you brought to the world? How did you show them the path of Islam? May Allah make it easy for all of us, plus me, because we're all learners. I am learning as I go along as well. And we shall all learn together, like I say to my kids. You know, show me, tell me what you want to do. I will support you. Be it in Islamic way or whatever way, as long as you are going to benefit the society. So do we all from today agree? Let's agree. You know, we don't want to say that. We will all support our parents in helping us to get Islamic education. Yeah? Because that's one of their responsibilities upon you. Yeah? Do we all agree?
Yes.
Do we all agree?
Yes.
I bet if I get home and call one of your parents and say, oh, Mommy Doroji, what happened, sir? Did what we had the other day at the, you know, at the madrasa, we were talking, any changes? Ah, you're on your own, nothing like that. We
We don't want that. Yeah?
Do we agree to make a positive change?
We want to be good examples for our community. Is that okay? Now, I just want to ask a quick question to anyone here. I just want someone to just tell me what they think is their responsibility towards their parents. Anyone? Pardon? To listen to your parents, yeah? Thank you so much. So one of them is for you to listen to your parents. Because, wallahi, your parents know better than you think. If you think you know better than them, no. How many years have you spent in the world? Your parents have spent more. So they know the better ways of the world. Okay? Now, I'm just going to summarize it, you know, our obligation to you guys, you know, your duty to us as parents, okay? So, Islam imposes different duties upon children towards fathers and mothers, such as respecting them, okay? They should utter a word that can get them angry, nor oppress them, nor do anything that gets them sad. Don't say to them a word of contempt.